Hello, everyone. I'm Lord Stencil. I'm Lord Stencil, and this is my lover boy, Brucey Poo. <All right. laughs> Hi, everyone. My name's Lord Stencil, and we're here. We have three topics, correct? Right?
There's more, but...
Let's just do...
We're just kind of winging it, because our first time...
Yeah, it's our first podcast. Yeah. Style.
So we have a few topics that we're going to go over, and then... A game on here that we were gonna play, but I don't have it downloaded on this computer, so we can't do that.
We might just do three topics and move on. We might do some other event, maybe in our minds. We're gonna probably cut some it out when that happens. But the three topics: console versus PC, new games coming out or already out for the consoles, and then our favorite childhood games.
Yeah, it's like a top five. So I got my five, and he's got his five.
Yeah,
it's going from. The least, or from five down to one, one as being our favorite of all time.
Mm-hmm. So, you want to start with the first topic of console versus PC. What would you choose?
The three topics we chose that we're going to be basing them on are graphics, the games, and then the online play. For the graphics, I think the PC has a lot. We're both PC gamers, so we're probably going to be more for the PC.
Yeah.
But I think PC has a lot more wide range for graphics because all you do is just get a better graphics card and it's...
Disclaimer, we have done console stuff. We haven't recorded with console, but we've used to be console fanboys. He was Xbox, I was whatever because I...
And he still got like a PlayStation 3,
yeah,
so...
Yeah, PS3.
I just got rid of my Xbox not too long ago because I was just getting stuff for my PC because I just like PC more. It's a lot better, I think.
For what I gotta add to the graphics, though, is he's actually 100% right. It's a fact. PC has unwide range of graphics. The consoles can't boot. They could. But honestly, who's gonna want to take the time and money to sit there and put new graphics into a freaking console, which might also use dedicated, plugins and stuff like that to get it to work. PC, it's literally just, you buy, you clip it in, you're done. You had to download drivers and such.
Mm-hmm.
It's not bad.
It may seem complicated, but it's really not. It kind of is a little bit on the money side, but once you have it for a very long time. The PC don't upgrade in new consoles where you gotta buy another $500 console. How the 360 did that just recently.
I never thought about that. That's actually 100% right. PC gamers, back when I was a kid, I used to play the computer all the time. I'd play... RuneScape, Fate, all these little crappy kid games. RuneScape wasn't a kid game, but I played it because my brother played it. But anyway, I never thought about it like that, actually, because Xbox Original came out on PS1, and the PS1, you had to buy a PS2, because PS2 came out, and PS1 was outdated. It's crappy. Xbox 360 came out, you had to buy Xbox 360, because Xbox Original, outdated. Online shut off. Stuff like that. You had to spend money through time, which a lot of people, it's not a big deal. And it's not, but for others, it's extremely easy. Literally, just stay with the PC. The only thing that you'd have to do is maybe if a graphics goes so over, you have to buy a new graphics card. Or even just get a new CPU. But it's honestly not as expensive as wasting freaking $500. And if you buy the best that there is out right now, or at least the closest to the best, you're set for years.
We just got off topic about graphics, but we're going to show... Probably in the corner, between PlayStation and somewhere.
Maybe right here.
In this area. I don't know where the camera's showing, but we're going to have consoles probably on this side.
That's my face.
And the PC. You're understanding the point, but the PC graphic on this side of the same game. So we're probably going to use Grand Theft Auto since you have it.
Yeah.
We'll have the Xbox's graphics and then the PlayStation's graphics and we'll have the PC's versions of the graphics.
Let's continue from the graphics to the games. For exclusives, there's honestly, there's so much more exclusive for PC. Outstandingly a lot. There's strategy games that are exclusive for PC. Arma, which a lot of people will probably, if you've never heard of Arma, it's awesome. He has Arma 2 and 3. I convinced him to get 3. Mm-hmm. I bought the Supporters Edition of 3 before it was even out, because I love 2. It's one of those games that, it'll be frustrating because you can't win that easy. But
it's really just realistic.
Yeah, it's just an
It's a simulator, so it's made to be like that.
But it's so fun to do, like, other things. Like, people have Arm of Life, Arm of Wasteland. You know, other things like that. And it's really neat because it shows how people can create the game into something that's fun. Because, I mean, life's not hard. The only thing that's hard in it is not getting caught by cops and killing cops. Because cops are extremely overpowered. But besides that, it's a really fun game. If you have any other exclusives that you'd like to bring out.
The only other exclusive would probably be, like, games that were made to be made by actual people. Like, Gary's Mod, for instance.
Yes.
Like, the modding...
Oh, no.
The modding, like, the modding community is, like, really high for PC, and it brings out new gaming ideas. Like, DayZ came from Arma. It was, like, a mod they made in Arma that eventually just turned into a new game. And
it gives people a lot more opportunity to do stuff.
Yeah, like, just new game modes, new characters, better roleplay, if people are into roleplaying.
Depending, a lot of people can be. I know a lot of you people out there.
For, like, on Xbox, you can't really, or Xbox or PlayStation, you can't really mod it, because you get in trouble and get banned, and it doesn't give you really a wide variety of change, so it's kind of the same.
You said, like, with the Xbox, you had to use, like, a flash drive and whatever.
Yeah, I had to get, like, Modio and... whole bunch of software is on the PC.
Exactly. Everything comes from us. But, like, I know PlayStation has that route to do it to where they can actually change everything. But again, as you said, you'd get in trouble. It's not as widely open and okay to do it as a PC would be, since PC was made to create games, so why can't you create games on a PC? So.
Also, to clear myself up, by modding, I don't mean hacking. There's a difference between a mod and a hack. A mod is an add-on to the game that makes it better. A hack is like cheating, like getting millions of dollars in Grand Theft Auto illegally. And
I don't count that as hacking.
All right, someone else did that for him by accident. That he kind of did that in mid-game somehow.
PlayStation 3, someone did it for me. PAC, I didn't really care. I was waiting for him. I was like, let's set up some money, because it takes forever to freaking earn money. I hate Grand Theft Auto's freaking ranking up and money system, because it sucks. Big ding-dong. I hate it. And I got banned for a week for it, so I'm getting punished, but I don't care.
Anything else you want to talk about in the game sector?
There was another thing. So clarifying your modding and hacking section, hacking is... making yourself better than someone else in a turn, like not like saying you have another skill.
You don't want to do the work for yourself.
Yeah, you want to have it like auto aim. People that are like, he has aimbot, like that's a hack. and that on would be as if like as and I wanted to use this as the whole reason I came back into it is because Battlefield 3 or 4, everyone thought there's gonna be a dinosaur mode. It's gonna be like zombies, but with dinosaurs.
I realized that I looked into that later and found out it wasn't even Battlefield. It was for Gary's Mod.
Really? It was the one that we saw. Yeah, I knew that was Gary's Mod.
It was a Gary's Mod version. Like Gary's Mod. We go into that game for mod. That game's based on modding, so you literally can it technically copies
the models from other games, and you can put them into that game.
And it legitimately looks exactly like Battlefield. If you look up, type in Gary's Mod Battlefield, you could find literally all the Battlefield maps, and the characters, and weapons, and how they run and everything.
The only thing that would be different from it is how hard the actual person that created the mod for Gary's Mod worked on how hard to actually make it look as a replica.
Yeah.
Like... I know in that Gary's Mod that you were looking at, the textures were a little iffy. That was mainly because the dude didn't work as hard to make sure that every little grass is there like Battlefield does.
Which I don't think Gary's Mod has that capability of that high of graphics, though, is why.
It might not, because it might have to be more compact.
Yeah, because I think it has to have lower polygons for it to do things in Gary's Mod.
But, no, I just wanted to clear that up. And a mod is where you can add like dinosaurs to Battlefield 4.
Yeah.
All right. And to online, because the communities, it's a really big part. PC, I feel like, is a lot like Xbox.
Yeah, it has a more sociable and, like, wide friendship going on in there. Like, Xbox is a really good community that has a way of communicating easier, actually just plugging your controller. Instead of, like, PlayStation you have to actually plug it into the...
Well, that's just to...
get the mic.
No.
Or is that something different?
Oh, the mic style?
Yeah, like have a mic you have to plug
in. That's because I don't have an actual PlayStation 3 mic.
No.
It probably is a lot easier with a PlayStation 3 mic, but I had only my Blue Yeti, and I just like, screw it, poop, right in the USB.
So he's got this giant mic playing a PlayStation. So you get a little headset thing.
But the thing is, like since,
no one talks.
Yeah, I've played through all the consoles. I've played PlayStation 2, never one. Actually, I did play PlayStation 1.
Yeah.
I played PlayStation 1, 2, 3, haven't played 4 yet, or Xbox One. I haven't played the new next-gen consoles.
Yeah.
But I played PCs, and I've talked to every single one of 360, 3, and PC. Out of all of them, the best one I had was probably PC, because everyone's a little more friendly in there. Because, honestly, you're not going to find that many kids. Because kids are like, controllers, blah, blah, blah. And they just ask their parents to go buy them consoles. Usually it's the more mature, or not even mature, it's just the more, I don't know how I would explain it. Like, the more, the geekier. And I hate to say it like that, because most kids nowadays aren't as geeky as, like, we are. Like,
yeah.
We get on the computer, we look at crap like that. But Xbox is full of nice people because no one really hates on it. I joined a PlayStation 3. I was really discouraged by this because I don't hate on little kids that play games because I used to do it when I was young. It doesn't matter, you know? It's just another gamer. It doesn't matter. But as I was getting with this PlayStation 3, I joined a ghost map because that was the only Call of Duty I had. And I was like, get down on some ghosts. And they started making fun of this kid just because he talked. He wasn't doing anything wrong. He was actually talking to me, asking me, hey, where's the other guy? It was a kid. He had a kid voice. The kid instantly started cussing him out and saying, shut up, you beeping kid. You know, it was ridiculous because it's like, what did he do to you? And I was really discouraged by the PlayStation 3's community. I'm hoping it gets better, but Xbox people are friendly. You'll find the occasional douchebag.
Mm-hmm.
But you find the occasional douchebag on the PC, too.
Yeah, the douchebags are everywhere.
Yeah,
there's no
avoiding that.
Yeah. And then there's those people that like to talk crap behind the console. It's like, just be friendly.
Like, what do you mean?
Like, they think nothing can hurt them behind the screen because they're talking shit and act like they're badasses.
Oh,
and like,
yeah. And then they...
No names.
Yeah.
Wait, who?
I can think of
it.
Sorry, that's all I can think of because I know Brian and him. Never mind.
Or those people that report you for no reason.
Yeah,
that pisses
I've never
you
had
off.
That, but
I've had that. I've had that where like you tell them like a certain football team sucked and they report you and you get banned for like a couple days because they can't prove that you did it, so they just ban you just in case you did, but they don't ban you as long. So if you get more and more reports on them, then they really look into it and ban you longer. But, yeah. I said the Bears suck. And he reported me for it, and I was banned for, like, I think 3 days off of Battlefield?
Jordan?
No.
Oh.
I don't play with Jordan.
Yeah, I don't know.
It was some kid I didn't know. It was just in there.
Bears! Bears! Bears suck. Reported!
Bears do suck, though. I don't like them.
No. I'm not a sport person. Yeah.
I'm not either. I just don't like the Bears. Because my girlfriend likes the Bears and she gets mad, so.
I
anyway.
Like Bears. They're grizzly and furry. I don't know. I'm talking about animals. Only other thing I have to say about online is PC can be a little unreliable for it. Cause
yeah.
Arma 3's multiplayer. And then this is
actually,
just,
no. With Xbox, I could never join Blake.
That's because of the close connection stuff. I hated that for Xbox. Because I tried to join my... John?
Yeah, you like try to join your friends that are close to you and you can't. It won't let you.
It's because you have to mess with your internet on the freaking PC and stuff. Like, you have to type in all this other crap. And it's like, I don't want to go through this. I have a moderate connection. Who cares if he has another moderate connection? I want to just join him and play with my friends on custom games on Halo. Just want to do it!
Because it would only do it at a certain time. Or I'd have to have another person in there in order for me.
I hated it.
It was so dumb. With PC, you just plug it in and say, hey, you got bad internet? Okay, it's gonna suck.
we still play if we have better internet. Like, I'm lagging. I'm still going, but I'm lagging. But no, with Arma, like, they are a little unreliable, and that's just because of the creators there. And I feel like it's because they're lazy. Because they just don't want to try to fix it.
They're kind of always worried about the next game.
Yeah, because it takes them, like, so many years to create the next.
It's because it's so big. The maps are so big and thought out.
Mm-hmm.
And the, I wouldn't say the models are so detailed. The houses are kind of plain.
The houses are extremely plain. They're just literally...
They put more detail in their grass.
Fuck the grass.
Yeah. I think they spend all the time... I think it's just because it's so big and so much coding goes into it.
Mm-hmm.
So much simulation goes into it that they kind of have to.
I mean, if you think about it, because
they spend like 12 years on a game.
I mean, if you think about it, because the beta testing and all that to make sure there's no broken spots.
Mm-hmm.
Think about how much they have to go freaking through. And especially with Arma 3, since you can do diving, so you can do stuff underwater now. You're going to be swimming randomly in the ocean, and whoop, you're going to go in through a black hole and fall through the world.
I guess you can't really test it all, because they do allow mods in it. So true. Some mods... You just have to, whoever's modded it for you is really who you have to judge for that, because they won't know until it's been done.
Yeah, but the Arma 3 maps.
Yeah. The maps are nice. The maps are really big.
Their online, though, isn't really reliable, because, like, if you play by yourself on campaign or editor or scenario, you'll get, like, I get 60 frames per second. Usually, like, I try to keep mine at a constant frame second instead of just letting go, whee! I keep it a constant thing. I play online, I've only got 25 or 30, or even, I've even been down to freaking 9. I hate it. It's random. It's
like when you go into the towns.
Yeah,
you can be outside. The crappy buildings are the ones that slow your frames down. They don't make any sense whatsoever, but it's still a fun game.
They always put stuff in. They're like, oh, we're going to put a man right here and a little sign here. This is where you buy crap. Yeah. Go in here and you're walking. Crap! Money disappearing. But let's get out of that topic, because wasted time.
New games. Yeah. Well, we planned on doing this podcast a while ago, so some of these games are already out. Okay, one of them already out. I don't think the other two, other...
Which one's out?
The Mortal Kombat X is already out.
Is Halo 5 out?
No, it's not. It comes out in... around here, it says October.
That's why you looked it up.
October 27th. October 27, 2015, so around fall-ish area is when that comes out. I'm really looking forward to that. Halo 5 Guardians, I've always liked Halo. It's been one of my favorite games. But
I like Halo, but this one.
I know, I'm just confused on what they're doing with the story, because they have two sides. They have the Spartan Locke, and then they have Master Chief. And they have both of those trailers, and then they both kill each other in both trailers. So I don't know if you're going to be able to, like, choose a person.
Inception.
I don't know if you're going to be able to, like, choose, like, a character, and you play through their story, and depending on who you choose, that's what's going to be the ending.
Might just have two endings, yeah.
So I have no idea.
It'd be on your... It'd be just... It's probably them trying to make you feel like you have a choice, when honestly, you don't. The whole campaign is probably set out. It's just...
I'm trying to think of a game that did that.
It's probably a lot of games that done that, to be honest.
Yeah, like... They do that. It gives you, like... It's like give you an option between like A, B, and C, and like you choose like A, but you
get the same ending.
You get different dialogue, but it's different ending.
Like I know, Walking Dead, the comic version where like you got to pick everything you do. It was mainly you got your own choose your own story, but for the most part, it always went to the same thing each time.
Yeah,
there's no way of avoiding it.
It's like certain people. I think it carried on to the next one too, though.
Yeah,
like,
it would.
If certain people lived, it would carry it on to the next.
But see, the main thing is almost every single... I remember the one girl that shot whoever you kept from the pharmacy.
Mm-hmm.
She accidentally shot him, whatever, and I was trying so hard to make sure she wouldn't leave. Each time. She either got killed, left behind, or she ran away. So I was like, why even waste the freaking time to try to save her? She's just going to leave anyway.
Yeah. I think she, from my, wait, which pharmacy?
The family pharmacy. The one that they went to, Lee's family owned.
Oh, yeah. Like the very first mission, pretty much?
Yeah. The very first episode.
Okay, the girl that was good with the gun?
Yeah.
She died for me.
Oh, no. You gotta save either the guy or the girl.
Yeah. The girl died for me. She got her head shot off.
Yeah, I know. She gets killed by the other girl.
Yeah.
On accident. The same way if you do save the guy, gets shot.
And about got in her pants, too, man.
What?
Lee was digging her. My guy was, at least. I'm pretty sure that's how it went for mine.
I've never had that.
That's just how it went in my head. Ooh,
man. Comics. Come
to Black Papa.
Anyway, we're getting extremely off topic.
We went from Halo 5 to soft black porn. And white girl sex.
Okay.
Halo. I'm going to read this straight from the thing. Halo 5 Guardian is upcoming first-person shooter video game, if you didn't know that. If you didn't play the last four. Part of the Halo
7.
Yeah. And this is the Master Chief era. Because
there's Reach.
Yeah, there's Reach and all that. But he's in that Wars. Too. But he kind of... Wars is not made by the same company, but...
By the technical
yeah, they are technically this Halo, but I don't know.
There's six Yeah. There's no number in gravity.
ODST.
Oh, that's right. It's on the 38.
There's a lot.
I forgot about ODST.
There's a lot.
I wish they'd keep doing it for PC. They did it for 1 and 2...
Yeah, I don't know why they stopped.
And then Microsoft bought them out, basically.
Probably.
Stupid. But the only reason I'm a little iffy on it is because it's 343. I like
Bungie. They've always been there.
I know, but they're doing their own
they're
story.
I'm pretty sure 343 is the one who made the story. I'm pretty sure. Don't quote me on that. I'm gonna look it up real quick. You keep talking.
Let's just move on to the next game while he's looking up something for the other game. Mortal Kombat X. I don't know much about Mortal Kombat. Let's move on.
It's awesome.
I just know when you play Mortal Kombat, you kill people. You do fatalities.
I think it's going by the books.
Yeah.
I think 343 wrote the books.
Actually, I think the first ones were going off their own thing, a little bit on the book.
Mm-hmm.
And then these ones are on the books. Purely on. Because I think in the books, they're going to talk more than about freaking rings. They're actually going to have more of a story. Because the first one didn't really have as much of stories. It was really just go destroy
rings. I guess these are the primary developers. There's Bungie.
But 343 wasn't in it until 2011.
They were Xbox, 360, Windows, iPhone. Oh yeah, they have another
Spartan.
One.
Nine.
Spartan Assault. I
Nine.
Forgot about that. There's Spartan Strike right here.
Uh-huh.
It was released this year.
10? 10 Halo games before 5. Yeah, let's just move on from Halo because it's a series that's not going to stop. There's a diehard fan base for it, really.
I don't know. Because it shows them killing them, and I don't think they can really make another Halo without going back to the Rebel Wars.
They'll find a way. I'm sure...
Like Call of Duty, their franchise is ending here soon. It's not the same thing over and over and over, just doing story. They honestly have the same thing going for them over and over.
I liked when Black Ops came out because it's like, oh, Vietnam. It's different. It used to be all World War II, and it's like, Vietnam. Let's go on, we're going up. And now... Black Ops 3, exosuits. Wait a minute, didn't they do that for Advanced Warfare? Oh, Advanced Warfare did the same thing! Oh my god!
So now you can run on walls.
Oh, Titanfall.
That's what they were originally going for with... Because the same person made the Titanfall.
Yeah, though actually it was people that left Call of Duty. They were like, I'm making my own shit. Fuck you.
And Titanfall was really successful. I actually liked that game. Have you played it?
I like the game, I hate the way it went out. I don't like online all the time. I like being able to do single
player. Yeah, that was... I had it for Xbox for a little bit.
Yeah.
That was before I had a PC.
Mortal Kombat X, there's not really much to talk about it, to be honest.
Unless
you want to go into the lore, but honestly, the game, though...
Wow, this... If you want to go back, I'll go through
everything. She did this, and he did this. Now they're both doing this.
Actually, they never have sex in that game. I see a lot of kids, but I never see sex.
You haven't been looking the right right? you remember maybe when you walk by that door and there's a little crack, if you just peek inside, you see Kane and Draco.
I kind of like how they did how they've done the new Mortal Kombat. How it's story based. Armageddon was pretty fun, but
I like that one. It was very story based. You went through and you fought.
This one's more cutscene based. It has like a cutscene and like interactable cutscenes. Like you press A if someone's like coming to attack you.
So quick.
Remember what it's called.
Quick button.
Quick button.
There we go.
But it's like it's quick reaction type deal.
Yeah! You just said it.
The quick reaction deals and
I think.
Yeah, but I have no idea.
I don't remember.
But it has those and like it's just basic cutscenes, and then when the fighting happens, you actually do the main game, you fight.
Yeah.
And then it goes on to another cutscene, and it like gets. You're not confused on the story. Except the first one kind of confused you because.
Dark Souls is kind of the same way.
I hate that game.
Pay attention, it's just extremely hard.
I hate that game. There's no.
See, my brother beat both. He beat one and two.
I don't like that game.
He doesn't like it because he can't win.
I can't get past the first mission. First boss!
All it is you have to time everything and you have to
strategize. Oh, I timed every footstep on me. I don't even know if he steps on you.
He does.
The very first thing. I don't remember.
If you get too close, you go.
I kept dying from the damn skeleton shit fuckers things.
Oh. That's after you beat the first boss, though.
I did eventually beat him. Oh. After the 16th try, and I'm already a zombie.
You're a hollow man. It's not a zombie.
It's a zombie.
No, it's not.
It means you're dead.
Nuh-uh.
It means you die.
Because the underworld and everything, I think, connect in the story. It's a really good story, actually. It's really nice. Anyway, that's not an upcoming game. Actually, technically, Bloodborne was. But it's already out.
Yeah, Bloodborne. Fuck it.
But I don't want to get into that, because it's not the Dark Souls. And there's only one save spot. If anyone's playing it and is like, where's all the other save spots? There's only one. I found that out by looking at the map and figured out that's the whole game. One map, one safe spot, no loading.
Have you ever... this is going back to Mortal Kombat X, but have you ever seen the fatalities in it?
Some of them, they're really weird.
They're very gruesome. They're getting a lot of shit for that, too. I don't know why. It's their game. It's like, if you
fucking Saw!
It's like, you don't want to... You don't... Yeah, Saw is pretty bad.
Saw is real life. This is freaking animated gore.
And, like, they're giving... It's like, if you don't want it, don't play it. Don't buy it.
That's the whole point of the game. That's why people wanted it back in like when it first started. Because it was bloody, it was gory, you'd rip off people's heads, and it was freaking pixels. Mm-hmm. They've been doing the same thing ever since, other than when DC and all that came out, because DC is not allowed to be gory.
Yeah, that's the only reason why.
But everything else with Mortal Kombat based only was gory. You gotta cry about it, you gotta cry. It's stupid. F you. Moving on to Tom Clancy's The Division. Actually, I heard a little bit of the story. It sounds really cool.
I haven't heard the story. I've just seen a little bit of the gameplay.
Supposedly, it's about, like... I was told it was about an infection. And it was kind of like a DayZ style.
Except no zombies, right?
Yeah, it wasn't a zombie infection. It was, like, an infection that would just kill you. Yeah,
like a flu
infection that would kill you. And people were trying to survive. And that's how The Division works.
Yeah.
But I don't know much else about it.
Is it pretty much Arma, but Ghost Recon? Type
deal?
It's
that's
like
what
open
kind of
world.
That's
of.
Kind of what Tom Clancy's like Rainbow Six. I played that when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. That sucked. Like, I remember you look at the map, you saw the lines where all your team was moving, and who died, would there be an X and all that. It was harder than freak. It sucked.
I think I still have the old Ghost Recon from that.
Yeah,
Tom?
Yeah.
I gave it to you, yeah. Tom Clancy has been around for a while. There's another Tom Clancy game that's coming that we have on here too, but. Tom Clancy's been a while. The Division, I think, is going to be really cool. It's kind of like the Future Soldier-based style. It's in that third-person, cover-behind-cover, futuristic type deal. And you just have a lot... Our women keep texting us, yeah. You just have a lot of options to hang out with friends, and it's like a really big, big map that you just walk around this abandoned city. There's a lot of things to do.
Is there other players or AI?
I think it's both. I think there's AI and players. But I think you can have, like... I don't know what the multiplayer aspects are. But I know there's with the new consoles, they're being able to get like 64 on 64.
Just like PC.
And the PC's I'm pretty sure it's going to be something big like that. Or they're going to have, like, you're like just walking, you can have like just like different missions that randomly pop up. You'll have like civilians that run out of nowhere, like giving you like just pop up objectives.
Money.
Or like you get a like if someone's flying over the UAV because they get the little remote control little UAV that goes invisible.
Little throwing guy.
And like those are like look out things, and they can tell like, say, hey, police station's being
robbed. Got a nine-er, grid 04, 5, 6, 7.
That's they're like they're getting robbed by the rebels or whatever the people are called in this.
It's not, I don't know why you're putting my hand in my eye. That's more of Aliens Clone Wolverine reference.
Hey.
Come in! There's an alien nearby. Let's
Siege. But Tom Clancy's Siege, I don't know when that's coming out. I've seen some gameplay on it.
I want to play it.
I really wanted to. There's another game that's in, I think, beta, or not beta, it's in like an early access that you have to get permission to play for free.
Of Siege?
No, of a different game. It's exactly like Siege, though, but it's not complete. The models aren't fixed yet. They're still adding. They're just fixing the gameplay at the moment. If you watch MySkirm's been playing it. Bob.
Is that the blocky one?
Yeah, the blocky one. I don't remember what it's called.
That's not Siege.
I know, but
I want 3D models that look like me.
They do. They're blocks.
Okay, see. You're me, huh?
But yeah, Siege is really cool because I like the police versus robber aspect. There's not a lot of games that have that.
Other than Grand Theft Auto, and Grand Theft Auto's taken over it, and Payday did, but they're not really that. Payday is big, but there's not that much Payday. There's a lot of Grand Theft Auto, and Grand Theft Auto's always had the stone for police versus robber crap.
Which I don't think they have that now.
Yeah, they do.
Do they still have that in the new one?
Police versus robber?
Yeah. Like the players as the police.
Yeah.
They do?
Yeah, it's like a police chase thing, I'm pretty sure.
I've never seen it.
But it's kind of disappointing because, like, I like Grand Theft Auto. Get me wrong. I hate the ranking up system for the online. It really sucks because I played it for 32 hours, only got to rank, like, 15. Which is extremely slow because I could get that in Call of Duty within 10 minutes. Well, not really. That's actually, like, one match. But maybe 5 matches I could get to rank 15. Extremely easy. It's not hard. And then it takes me freaking, like, 2 days almost just to get to 15 for online of Grand Theft Auto 5. And there's people that are level like 100 and something. And all I can think of is either you hacked or you got no life, brother, because that takes forever.
When'd you become Hulk Hogan, brother?
He's. Have you ever seen Battletime Buddies or Battletime Friends? Because like there's a corporal, because Battlefield also takes an extremely long time to level up. And there's people that are already level corporal on Battlefield 4. And they made fun of it. They're like, I got a bipod for my knife. It's just awesome. They actually add, like, that's what I like about Battlefield 4, and I know we're getting extremely off topic with the new games, but Battlefield 4, DICE, does listen to their players and everything. That's really cool. Back to Siege. I like the fact, I'm going to go to this because I'm really jumping around, I like the fact that you can play it tactically and still have fun, because, like, I watched someone play it, and it was the closed beta. I think you might be able to get that. We should really try and figure out if we can and get it, because that'd be really fun. But what they did is, like, they shot a tiny hole in one of the boarded up
windows. Yeah.
And they shot through
that
instead of breaking the whole thing, which I thought was really tactical. And it was extremely strategic, because then the other guys can't shoot you. They'd have to break the wood first. And then by that time, you're like, all right, get down. But no, Siege looks really cool. And I've only seen one map.
Yeah, there's only that one house that they showed so far.
But
I imagine there's going to be...
Even with that one house, it still looks
pretty awesome. Yeah, even with that one house, the graphics looked amazing. The gameplay looked solid. I didn't really see any bugging out or
like,
any glitches.
Have you ever played Tom Clancy's Vegas?
Yeah, it's like, exactly. It's what I think it's what it is.
It's basically Vegas, but a lot better game. Like, it's better graphics, it's better controls. Because I remember in Vegas when you sprint... Yeah. Turning! Or even when you're turning while just standing there, like, like it, you go slow motion and you go vroom, and you just swing. It's weird, but
I don't know. What are all the, you get riot shields with the police, you get not satchel charges, but like door charges, wall charges, and is that it for the police? I know you get better guns, of course, but you get like, flashbangs, but
yeah.
And then the robbers they had spike strips, they had barbed wire, they had traps, they had wall boards.
But if you think about it, that's what they're going to get, because I mean, they're boarding their defenses. Yeah.
And then I didn't know if they had any of the defenses. I didn't know if they had any like stun type deal.
No. And then they had the low grade weapons, the AKs, which doesn't have to be considered a low grade weapon, because if you've seen Counter Strike Go, there's a lot of people that get kills with AKs. But I'm pretty sure it's auto aim.
Sorry about that. My computer sucks at charging, so
I'm gonna hook this up real quick. But we are going to move on to our top five. I'm gonna start it since he's charging. My number five was The Sims 2 for PC.
Alright, we're good.
Oh man, if that was a good dude, I was going to bomb. But for The Sims 2 for PC, because this sounds really girly, because most women play The Sims. Screw you. But
it's fine, I was going to buy Sims 4.
But... my sister got it for Christmas, and I was like, whatever, like 7. And I was like, let's play it, yay, a game. So I played it, and it was really cool, because you could do anything you wanted. I remember my sister was actually taking it serious. I'd sit there, and I'd burn my people. I'd lock them all in the bathroom.
There's those people that are like, I gotta feed them. Oh no.
Yeah, my sister was like, read a book. You like reading a book. Read the book. And marry your maid. And I'm just like,
marry your maid.
Burn the people. So I'd lock them all in the bathroom. And I kind of spit. I'm sorry if I spit on you.
I think I'd probably like try to get with death. Yeah. Just murder people. And like you flirt with death when he comes.
Sims 3. I modded it. Because I had the Sims 3 now. And I modded it. And I was trying to make the neighborhood really cool. One of the neighbors was a murderer. I modded it so you can actually kill people.
So
I went door to door like, hello, and I banged him, and then afterwards, hammered to the face.
There's going to be videos of some gameplay of some of these if you've never heard of them, so then you can check them out. Up like in the corner of either up here or over here, probably in this area.
On my chest, because I'm
too... Yeah, on his chest.
But The Sims 2 was really nice. It was really different because most games don't let you do your own choices, and I thought that was really innovative for Sims 2. Now, you're number 5.
Oh, another fact on Sims 2 that what I heard, don't quote me, but I heard that
coming out with a number 6.
No, that's not it, but that's possible
to come soon after 5.
Yeah,
as soon as 5 comes out, maybe there'll be a 6.
Yeah.
Maybe.
But, like, they originally made it, so, like, they didn't plan on making Sims
a game.
They originally made it for, like... buildings, like how they were going to build a building up and where they were going to put the bathrooms, the bathtubs, and just simulate how people would interact with each thing.
Otherwise,
for agriculture, not agriculture, but architecture.
Yeah.
Like buildings, just like.
And instead, someone probably got addicted to it while they had it.
Yeah.
And they're like,
hey, let's turn this into a game.
Yeah, you make more money out of it. They obviously probably did. And then they got SimCity, which obviously is probably also another thing they tried doing. But, no, Sims 2 was cool. But not for his number 5.
My number 5 was Spyro the Dragon.
I like that game.
Yeah, I remember playing it when I was a little kid. Probably not when it first came out. Because I probably wasn't even born when it first came out.
You probably were.
When it first came out?
Yeah, Mortal Kombat was around 1998, I think, when it first came out.
So yeah, when it first came out, I don't remember how old I was, but I remember getting it, and I just remember shooting people with my fireball, and then I never actually beat the game. When I was that young, I never really beat any game.
I didn't
either. Because I was never really good at them. I just remember just playing them, having fun, just breaking the dragons. I remember the goddamn
people that stole your eggs.
The people like, yeah. And they chase you around. I hated that. I remember because we were playing it and I figured out a way to do it so easy now. And all you remember as a kid, I was chasing down everywhere. Like, stop! Stop! And I just like, I stop a little bit and then I fire my fire because it would catch up to them.
Yeah, I get those things made me so mad. The noise they made was, na 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 na. I'm like, no, 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 no. Just wanted to kill it. And then I forgot if they took their eggs or not. And I didn't really check if they had it in their hands. So I chased them anyways.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because then after you actually got them,
they respawn, but they wouldn't have the egg.
Yeah, so you just chased them anyway.
Yeah. I downloaded an emulator not too long ago for it. I'm going to try and beat it. I got number 2 also. That was another favorite of mine.
I like the one where you go to like this Japan land area. And
the Japan land?
That might be
the
second one. Like, you had to dodge a little thing. It's weird.
It looks Japan-oriented. I don't remember. There's a lot of them since then.
I don't know. But it was really cool, though, because you, like, teleported to a different land, and it was, like, a pirate-themed.
Yeah.
Is that the second?
I think so.
Yeah. That's the one I was talking about. I like that one. That one was probably my favorite, because it was really cool. It was just really different. But,
you don't know?
Yeah. You got anything else to say about Spyro?
There's too many for me to play. I haven't caught up on Spyro in a long time.
Is it really a lot?
Yeah, there's a lot.
Oh, yeah, well, there's Skyland now, too.
Yeah, there's Skylanders. I love that game. You don't even see Spyro very much.
Because you're playing as all the other ones.
All the other ones, yeah. All right, your number 4?
My number 4 is Halo. Not for Halo 1 nor 2. It's mainly based across all of them. Or mainly 3, Reach, and 4. Because, well, not really 4. Because I didn't like the custom games, I liked it, but no one really did it. I didn't have a lot of friends to do it with. Like, I didn't really play with you that much when I was playing Xbox.
Yeah, we didn't really become friends until this year,
which is when I was more into PC. It wasn't even this year. It was like
this year.
Is this year?
Yeah. Oh, it's beginning of this year.
Oh yeah, that's right. Because I was on welding was.
Yeah.
I don't remember when I had. I thought it was last year. I thought it was the end of last year.
It was beginning of this year. Because we went all to that football game.
Yeah, but we also had weldings when we first talked, yeah. And then I started dating Savannah. Anyway.
Yeah. not about our love life. But.
Halo was really cool for custom games because I love playing Reach with friends. Or 5. I loved 5, too, because I would play, like, Ghost Hunters.
Halo. Or, Halo. 3! We have a sneak peek to 5!
I'm not a beta tester! 3 was really cool because, like, in Foundry, people would make little cities, like little towns, and it was so cool because I'd walk around and we'd play, like, tag or one's a zombie, and it was so funny because we would. In Foundry, how there's that back, like, hallway or whatever, and then the 2 rooms. Well, we would be able to barricade one of the rooms, and we would just sit in there like, get away! And then the other dude would have a freaking gravity hammer, and he had to break in. And we had to escape somehow. It was the stupidest concept.
You locked yourself in.
Yeah, you locked yourself in. You had to somehow get out.
Oh, yeah, okay, he's coming in that door. We just barricaded it.
Don't know
when he breaks it, we're gonna run.
That's what you had to do.
We're gonna run.
It was so funny.
Actually,
no, it wasn't even that. It was you had to get the door open while he was stuck behind, like, it was a teleporter thing.
Yeah.
He had to break every single thing and get through all these other barricades to another teleporter, which would teleport him behind us, and we had to open a door before he did that to get out.
So, you remember, have you ever played any of the Halo Saw maps? Mm-mm. They were awesome.
What would you do?
You need to look them up when you're here. While we're talking about it, I'll show a little video of their Saw map. You can keep talking about Halo.
Okay. But, no, it was so funny because if you got out, by the time you actually got out, the guy got in. So you're just like, run! Run! Leave the guy behind! He's slow! You just try to throw your friends behind you, and I'm really curious about this. Hold on.
I was 5 when I rolled my
I'm going to this place.
But here's I'll probably find this.
We'll put this up. We're all gonna watch it at once.
I'm gonna turn the volume down.
So
we, like,
not a cheesy name.
We're watching Z Royals video, so that this would be his video.
We'll put a link to his thing.
His thing, so you can see it too. But like through the Saw maps, like these are, it's like you had to make your way through these mazes, and like there's actual troop like places that, because they can put, if you put a mongoose up close enough to a wall, it'll say you can get in it, and you'll face the wall, and you'll be just in this room that's full, like there's no way out, and you gotta find where the mongoose is placed, and you have to get in the mongoose and face through the wall. Like, it'll probably show one in this, but there's different booby traps. Like, if you were to pick up that, you would, it would come down and crush you. It'd fly through, forward and crush you. It'd crush you in there. And it would deploy that shield there so you couldn't get through. And then there's just a whole bunch of traps and everything that'll come at you and kill you. There's a lot better ones than this one, but there's, that guy just got screwed. And there's different, I think there was like a good 6 maps that you could download to play. And they were just really fun to play. And it took me forever to figure out how to get through them. And there, another map, one is called Donkey Kong, if you ever played it. Have you heard of it? It's just literally just a giant ramp that went up like this. And those kill balls, you would just have them spawn vehicles in them and just have them blow up, and the pieces would fall, and you'd have to hurry up. You could get to the top the fastest.
Yeah. And down.
Those were fun.
In Halo Reach, I would do a custom game. I actually made it, and it was whoever made it to the bottom first won, and it had to have kill balls that didn't have any physics, and they just rolled out after you. And you had to get in a car.
That's when you had to drive down.
Oh, no. You had to drive down fast because it was a big ramp. It was on Forge Island. Yeah. And, well, we had those reflecting walls to where it's like the one ways. So if you hit the red X, it would just boost you back.
Mm.
Well, the red X is this way. So when you come down, you go, whoop, whoop, you just get pushed back and run into a kill ball. It was a lot of fun. But
once. So, it's like a trap. It was a trap they activated earlier. I think they're stuck. They're trying to get this out of the way because their friends are stuck back there. But other than that, or it might be a thing, because there's a lot of parkour in this game, that in this map, that some of them. I had this map. I actually had this one. There's a couple others. There's none on here, but another maps that I liked is they actually recreated all the Call of Duty Nazi Zombie maps in Halos.
Yes,
and those were fun.
That was awesome. I never got to play with a lot of friends on this, sadly, because like no one really. It just wasn't enough.
The only thing I had a problem with that is because of the Xbox, I couldn't join anyone.
Oh, yeah.
So it was like rarely that I ever got to play with Blake or anyone that I could join. It was like at certain times I could join him, but other times it's like, no, you can't join him. Sorry, fuck you. Hey, fuck you, man. Can't play them.
But Halo was just an extremely fun game to play with friends and everything. Like, custom games were awesome. I thought it was a really good mode. And why are they going backwards?
I don't know. I think they're trying to find their way out, because this one was confusing.
Alright, well, we should probably stop this. We've had enough of the video. That way we can at least continue on and keep a nice schedule. But Halo, in other words, was a lot of fun to play with friends. Like, have you ever played Garbage Man?
Mm-mm.
Garbage Man was so much fun. It was like Donkey Kong, but you're stuck in a room with one ways and you can't get out.
Yeah.
And someone up top, the zombie, basically has to kill you all by destroying vehicles, by throwing them down to this pit where a kill ball or something would destroy it. And all the pieces. Yeah, and the pieces just get flung down as fast as they could. It didn't roll. Mm-hmm. They got flung down. And it was so funny because at one moment you'd be standing there and this little piece of a mongoose would go, boom, we just whack you right in the face, and you'll just be dead. Your friends are like, ha, ha, and then laughing at you.
And then you could have they had the theater mode, so you can actually rewatch.
Yeah, you can just watch it over again.
And I always had fun with those. There's a game mode I made before I even knew it was a game mode. It was the bumper cars. It was called Warthog or like Warhog cars or something like that.
Yeah, that was technically a game.
Probably or Bumper Hogs. Bumper Hogs is what I called it. I called it Bumper Hogs.
You probably.
I've never seen it before, and I'm like, hey, let's put some make a square platform with kill balls underneath this thing and run into each other. For the last one standing wins.
I know on there though they didn't have kill balls. They used just the death zone.
Oh, what I did is I made in Halo 3 is when I had it. It was just the fusion coils. I just made them. Or I made the platform really high, and then if you fall, you die. But there would be fusion coils underneath the thing, and they would just constantly explode. As I put like grav things, and it just bounce around and explodes, and they would respawn like that. So if you fell off, they exploded.
But there's honestly a lot to talk about Halo, but we're not gonna get into full detail. What I'm gonna say I liked about it for a kid, child, like Tom Wild, whatever crap. Is the whole playing with my friends, you know, custom games.
My number four was Crash Bandicoot, Wrath of Cortex. Another game I did not finish.
I think I might finish that one, actually.
All these games I'm going to list, I've never beat them. Never beat them at all. Crash Bandicoot, I recently got and re-beat it. Or beat it. Because I didn't beat it before. And it was probably my favorite Crash Bandicoots, just because it was better graphic at the time, and I just liked it. Because I liked how the different masks were incorporated, the water mask, yeah. The fire mask, and just how those were in there, and then you played as the new Crash. And all the bosses were the same person, but they just had all those different people, and it was really fun to play as. And I liked the plane battling the most.
Yeah, that was fun, actually. I remember that.
Like, how you could go in and get the most of the missions. But now that I play it today, I beat that game in, 20 minutes.
There wasn't much gameplay to it.
No. The only hard part is to go back and get every single crystal. That is a pain, and I would not do it again.
See, now good day games are you get 32 gaming hours out of this. And back then, it's who cares how many hours you get? You gotta collect everything to win 100%.
In order to get the alternate ending to actually beat the game, you had to get all the crystals.
Yeah. What was the alternate ending?
It was the real ending, is what it was. If you didn't get all the crystals, it'd be like, hey, we've imprisoned them. It's okay, they didn't get all the crystals. We'll just unprison them again. If you get all the crystals, they permanently imprison the masks, and they can't be resurrected back. But if you didn't get them all, they'll be like, hey, it's all right, they didn't get all the crystals, they're dumbasses. Let's just resurrect the people back and start this over. Yeah,
I remember that. Because they made fun of you for it.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah, spoiler alert. I guess to number three. My number three was Delta Force. I just actually had it changed.
Yeah, I don't know that game. I've never seen it.
Delta Force is... It's kind of like an arma. That's the only thing I can really compare it to, because it wasn't a simulator style.
Yeah.
But it was a military simulator style. It wasn't a, shoot, dead. It was you more shot a couple times, Call of Duty. But you did tactics.
Was it more like a SWAT type deal? Or was it military?
It was military. You went out and, Afghanistan. And it was kind of funny because I remember the grenades when the explosions went off. It was like a freaking nuke, but it was so small and it was 2D. So every time you moved, it just followed you when it exploded.
Oh, it was that old of a game?
Yeah.
Gosh.
But it didn't look terrible, but it had terrible explosions. Extremely terrible explosions. There's not much else to say about it. MX versus ATV, I didn't have much to say other than I loved it crashing the planes. That was the only fun thing out of it all.
You get helicopters in that game.
Or helicopters in a crash. The helicopter.
Alright, my number three is Wario Land 4.
Never played it.
That game was awesome. Just because it had little mini arcade games inside the game. It was it was a Game Boy game. So you had your the purple Game Boy, and there's a baseball game in there. It was every time you'd hit it, you get coins, and every time you could buy new stuff. And you had to turn it this way, and hit it, so when the ball came, And, like, it would screw with you every once in a while because the ball would kind of, like, do a loop-de-loop or something. And, like, come down the plate and, like, you'd swing. It was a pretty fun game. And then I never beat it because I could never... Because when you get the key, you have a certain time limit to get back to the portal that you have. And I always couldn't find my way back. There was, like, so many... The maps would sometimes go on forever. And you would have to, like a five-minute timer to go all the way back.
Like, I bet you if you played it now, I'd be like, oh, look at that.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a straight path right here.
I still have the game, but I don't have a Game Boy anymore.
Oh.
I can play it on DS, but I don't have a DS. Wario is probably my second favorite of the Mario franchise. I like Mario, and then Wario, then Yoshi, and so on.
I didn't get into Mario as much as most people usually do nowadays. They're like, Mario's so cool, it's so retro. And I'm just like,
you know what'd be cool? Nintendo Mortal Kombat.
That'd be crazy.
Mario just shoots like a fireball.
Technically, they had that. That's Super Smash Bros.
Except without
but gore. Without gore. Yeah. They can't do gore, man. It's not allowed.
Looks like I'm making a fan game. Super Mario X.
But I'm a Mario. But
enough topic.
I guess I'll move on to my number two, which is actually technically my number one. I'm switching my number two and one around because right. I liked Obscure a lot. That's my number two now. Because I feel like my number two should be my number one because I played that game countless and I still kind of do sometimes, but not really anymore.
Mm.
But don't ruin it for anyone. We're going to let number ones be number ones. I won't explain your number one and you won't say mine. Obscure was fun. It was what got me the thrill of horror. And it wasn't really that scary. Now I played it and it's like, whatever. It's not scary. It's, actually, the first part still kind of is. Like, you're walking through a graveyard as the dude. And it's kind of cool because you're college kids. So you kind of get the vibe of like, man, let's get high, because that's what happens. They're literally crushing up flowers.
I think that's what the time
period smell this. It smells awesome,
I think that's
right?
What the time period was at that point, too, when it came out. It's like everyone was into that.
Yeah, they're all into smelling new stuff.
Yeah.
But
they were smelling it.
And they smelled it, and then actually, you know, everyone's a monster. Like, they literally turned into a monster if you smelled it. And for some reason, actually, the character smelled it, and you don't become the monster. Maybe you were, actually, slowly, but not surely. But it was so cool, and I actually beat that game, and it was awesome and scary. It was a Resident Evil kind of scary, like, you're running out of ammo, and you're like, get back! Get back!
I didn't like those type of games, because you always ran out of ammo so quickly.
Well, the thing is, you actually didn't use ammo, you used melee weapons.
Kind of like a... Rising Dead, I think it was called.
Dead Rising.
Yeah, Dead Rising.
Rising Dead.
Same thing. Different order.
Yeah, but you can use ammo or guns and that.
Yeah.
But it's still extremely low. But yeah, it was basically that. But you weren't allowed to control your camera freely. Or you were, but not in certain areas. Like, there's one place you walk in, you have to stare at from the corner angle. But it was a fun game because if anyone knows my channel, I play horror games or anything else. It's just kind of fun. But horror games for the most part because I like the adrenaline rush. It's fun because you get scared and you get on the edge and you're like, oh. And I even get that though with Call of Duty. Like in the multiplayer matches you're about to win, you're like, oh, get this no scope, chainsaw. I don't know. But I liked that feeling. That is my number.
My number two is Tiny Tanks.
Never played that one either.
It's about this little yellow, tiny yellow tank that you played
robot
as.
Robot tank.
And it was kind of the, comical, not really comical.
Robot.
It was just more the obscure humor at the time. Like, cussing, just bleeping out the words and, like, just using a lot of obscured words at the time.
Vulgar
words that were all bleeped out. Just
what's a mature teen?
It was more like a
no. Like it was the rating, rating was it mature?
It was teen. It was like it was trying to like humor. It was like trying to humor the teens. It was trying to humor teens.
Well, I guess back then, at the time, though, teens would have not have been allowed to cuss. They would have had to, like, follow the rules. And nowadays, you get kids cussing out adults. It's like, what happened?
And, like, it didn't... The story, it was really... It was, like, the whole story, the only way you knew the story is to play the game, because, like, throughout the game, it was just, like, a radio announcer, like, talking the whole time. And, like, you just aimlessly... You could pretty much go through the game without killing a single thing.
Really?
Yeah, it's like one of those type games. You just could pass through it. Well, maybe not. Except the boss that you had at verse. You could kill
the boss. The cracking is, it's my thumbs.
I don't think they can hear that.
I hope not. But I started thinking about it. I'm like, probably something my camera's going out for them.
But it was a really good game at the time. I never beat it because... Oh, it had multiplayer. I forgot that. It had multiplayer. It had multiplayer. It was like one was a purple tank.
So it was like tanky.
Yeah, kind of.
Like, have you played tanky?
No.
You've never played tanky?
No.
People played on the Chromebooks at school.
Wait, where like you elevate the tanks and shoot?
No. No, tanky is like, it's like World of Tanks, and it's like a Call of Duty World of Tanks. You're literally just this little tank that you can upgrade. And you play this tiny little crappy map. And you just drive around and shoot. You shoot in the tanks. That's all it is.
This one, it was just player versus player.
Oh, so it was only two players.
It was only two players. Which I don't know. I didn't have internet at that time. So it was just me and my brother playing. And it would be just like you randomly go around picking up like weapons. And like use them to fight each other.
Yeah.
And that's about all on that. It's just a lot... A multiplayer that we played because I couldn't ever beat the game, so I just played multiplayer with Trenton, and we just killed each other over and over. Couldn't really beat the game because it was hard at that time, period.
So
I sucked at games.
Should we move on to number one?
Oh my god, number one.
Alright, number one for Stencil is... RuneScape, which a lot of people, there's a big fan base for that. Even Nate Neely, has a giant fan. I don't think he's a giant fan, but I think he is. He still talks about it today, like he's still trading and everything in that game, because they added that big thing behind them. I don't even know what the town is. It's like the second town you can go to. Or it's not that you can't go to, it's like the closest town to the start.
Yeah.
And they added that big trading thing back behind it. And people go there, they sell things cheaper than what you would regularly get them where you can't find it. And it was just really cool. I loved the game when I was a kid. Because I played it back when the tutorial was... I think it was in a cave. And you didn't have anyone talking to you. You literally ran through and killed goblins.
I think that's when I played it too.
Because my brother played it. And I remember his password was money. It's not anymore because I always hacked into it. But it was money. And I was such a little kid because I would go and I'd play and I'd run to some random place that I thought no one would go to, drop most of his money, and I'd change, log out and go to my character and go to it. And the money wasn't there and I couldn't figure out why. And I figured out later on, now I think about it, it's like there was different servers. There's like US 1, US 2, US 3. And I'm sitting there probably leaving money for some random guy to go pick up and be like, "Woo! We got money!" And I'm just like, "Where's the money at?" And also get all like, "You douchebag, you're losing my money." Well, luckily he had it all in the bank and I just dropped whatever he had on him. But no, that game was just so much fun. Like, I think I did almost every single mission you could without premium. Except for one, because you had to break into a house, and I never knew how to lockpick it. I never knew how to get into the door. I probably could now, but I don't remember the password for my character, so it's kind of a waste of time. But I had, like,
Do you have to pay for it now?
No.
You don't have to pay for it?
It's still free. But I had the teal armor, There's, like, black is the highest one that you basically can buy. Mm-hmm. And then it goes to teal, this, like, purplish, bluish color. And then it goes to this purple color, I think. Or is it purple or teal? I think it's teal. It goes teal, and then it goes to, like, this purple, and then gold. I'm pretty sure. Don't quote me on it, because I don't remember, because things have changed a lot. But I still, I've gotten on it time to time to play with, like, I think I've tried playing with you on RuneScape, haven't I? Mm-mm. Or is it just some random, probably some random person on PC?
We never played RuneScape together.
You wanna?
No.
We got our, we got better games.
Yeah, we got better than the Dreams.
But no, it was just such a fun game as a kid.
I never really got into those type games.
I only got in because my brother was into it, and as you know, like, well, I guess you don't know because you're the
I don't have an older brother.
I'm the youngest in my family. He's the oldest. But
like, I'm skinny. He's
I do that. I do what you do. The whole say nigger all the time, and I've been starting to do it because I think I hang out with you too much, and you're a bad influence on me.
I'm trying to stop saying it because it's a bad name for people.
There you go.
I'm gonna have to bleed a lot of this out on my end.
I don't care, you guys.
Might as well get
we actually haven't cursed or said bad things lately. I mean, and probably things under our breath, but also you gotta realize, and I didn't think about this till now, the mic's on the camera, not on us. We didn't record separately with a mic on, like, a camera, on a computer.
Yeah, no, that's why we gotta talk loud.
I know, that's why I've been kind of yelling everything I've been saying.
Oh, well, we can enhance it.
The next one we do will be a little more prepared and think more about
I'll bring my mic, because it has an actual USB.
Not USB. What's wrong with mine? It's right there.
It don't have a... yours is USB, isn't it?
Yeah.
Mine has an actual auxiliary cord. The audio cord. The thing that actually plugs in your computer.
USB plugs into your computer, too.
Yes, I meant it for on the camera.
We don't need it for camera. We just use Audacity and just match them up.
That's dumb.
That works so much. Well, it doesn't work easier, but it's still easy to do. Who cares? We're not talking about our technical problems.
God damn.
Let's go to his number one. Because I kind of like it.
Okay. My number my number one.
Number one. We gotta go on?
Interrupting number one in three. Two. One.
Number one.
My number one is PlayStation demo discs.
Amazing! I wonder if anyone that even knows what they are anymore.
I don't know.
They're so old.
Because now you can just download demos.
Yeah, there's no demo disc back in the day. There was no
really internet.
Yeah, well, there was internet, but no downloading demos. So they let out demo discs, and it was so awesome.
They were free discs too.
Did you realize also that because demos are free?
Yeah.
But did you realize that there's actually a demo disc that would delete all your data? There was one of them. They screwed up somehow, and it would delete all your saves.
Dumb.
Because I think in one of the games on there, you could actually it was a gaming like creepypasta style.
Yeah.
But it was an actual true story that actually happened. Someone bought a demo disc and it didn't work. Or it did! But the game allowed you to save. Like one of the demos did for some odd reason. And when you did this, I think, it would completely delete everything.
That's weird.
And the kids that did this were ticked off, obviously.
Yeah.
They had a recall them all back or something. That, I guess. I don't know. Don't quote me. I'm pretty sure I hear this online, and you know the internet's always right. So.
Oh, yeah.
The internet's always
right. We're right, too. We're 100%. We're getting this all from the internet and this document that is in front of our screen.
Untitled document?
Because
you never took the time to name it?
Yeah, it took us a while to figure out where this document went because I didn't name it. But, and it just went black. Okay. Nick.
What about the demo discs that you like?
Like, everything on them. Like, it's just free, like, 30-minute games that you get to play. Like, you get from racing games. And you can actually play two players on these demos. And you're like, why buy the game? You got this demo you can play over and over and over.
Exactly.
And then, like, you get sneak peeks of new games that were coming out, which I never bought. I just kept playing the demos. And
that demo discs, now that I think about it, were kind of like pirating.
Yeah.
Because you just played it over and over again. You got the same excitement each time. And we were kids. We had a short attention spans. This entertained us.
I remember the one game. It was like a military game, which I wanted the full game for it, but I just kept playing the demo.
was it? I don't know the name. But it was like it was an old style game, and it was like the horrible textures. And it was a military game, and you're on this train. You're on top of the train, and you're walking through this train, like on top
of it. Was it Medal of Honor?
No, it wasn't Medal of Honor. No, it was horrible graphics.
Well, Medal of Honor back in the day had really crappy graphics.
It was not Medal of Honor. I know that for sure. Because it wasn't this Snake or whatever his name is.
Was it what?
It wasn't that any well-known guy that I know. It
was Medal of Honor. Yeah, I think you're thinking of Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
It wasn't World War II.
No, it wasn't Medal of Honor. It was a third-person type deal.
Oh.
It was very third-person. No, it was a military. It was straight military. It was like a SOCOM, but it was not a SOCOM.
Was it World War II based?
Nope. It was like modern day based.
Was it a modern conflict or some conflict?
No. I played that.
That game was fun.
That's Counter-Strike. Yeah, that was Counter-Strike. Global Terror. And like there's Desert Storm. And there's SOCOMs that are like that too. But it was just
Counter-Strike.
What is it called? No, not Counter-Strike.
Something Conflict.
Conflict is what I'm thinking of.
Counter-Strike is a PC game.
Yeah, yeah. But it was just a really weird game. You're on a train, and you gotta, like, your enemies were white. You were, like, dark green. The enemies were bright white.
Was it, like, army soldier style thing?
Yeah, it was army soldier. Tours? It was just one guy. You were only one guy.
Rambo?
No, it was not Rambo. Was there even a Rambo game?
Yeah, there's a Rambo game.
I didn't know that. That's awesome.
It's Rambo. It's such a big franchise. They have to make a game for it.
I didn't know that. I want to buy it. But it was really weird. At the end of the train, I don't even remember what happened at the end of the train. I think he just got picked up in a helicopter and flew off.
And that was the end of the game?
That was the end of the demo.
That was stupid.
That was an awesome demo.
I would hate that. You just freaking walk down a train, demo's over.
Well, you're fighting people on the way down.
Still, trains aren't that big. I mean, they are big, but they're not that big for a demo.
No. But it was
especially for a game.
I kept dying a lot, okay? It took me a while to finish the demo.
I remember the demo that I played on there was... Oh, what's it called? Markiplier just played it. Lost Souls? No. The Ghost with the Girls.
I understand what you're talking about.
What was that called?
I don't remember. Dread Out? No.
No. Dun 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 da da dun 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 da da dun da 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 da. We're looking up answers.
Mark.
We like Markiplier.
Yeah, he's our inspiration.
That's the face that comes up.
That's the face that comes up.
Okay.
Of course, he's male melons.
What?
It is. You've made a lot of videos since this.
Yeah,
it was recent too. Okay, so he's a
Fatal Frame.
There we go.
Or Final Frame? No.
Yeah, Final or
Final Fatal Frame 2.
Yeah,
I played. I think I played 2. I don't remember.
I've never played it at all.
I remember it was just the demo. It scared the crap out of me. I didn't know how to play. It just scared me so bad because I remember you'd be walking through this hallway and all you'd see is ghost hands. And I was a little kid. I was like, I hated it. I didn't hate it, but it was so freaking scary because I'm pretty sure it was Fatal Frame because if you stood still, a girl's face would pop up because I didn't want to move on. So I was like, put the controller down. And his face came out, I'm like, I'll move. It sucked.
Because you like when little kids playing horror games, it's funny because like
you're trying to stop me.
You're like, I don't want to go forward.
I do that now.
I don't want to go forward. I quit. Take the game back. That's the very first Resident, not the first Resident Evil, but I don't know what Resident Evil. But Dad bought it or not bought it for me. He rented it for me. Thought I'd like
4?
It. No, it was an older.
Resident Evil 4 is scary.
It was
crap.
An old one. It was when the zombies were zombies. And like
Outbreak,
it probably was.
something like that. It's like, was really nice. I don't remember who the character was, but like you'd walk in there and like the woman would be hung herself, and like you'd get to grab the item and you'd walk out, and then it was like, hey, you forgot something, and it made you go walk back in, and she was gone. I'm like,
I quit.
Oh my god.
Where did she go?
I'm like, there's
a woman there. She is breaking role playing right now. Why is she get off the rope to get milk?
And next, like, out of the corner of this, like, the TV, you have these box TVs at the time.
Dinosaurs. You get here.
I'm like, nope. I'm done. This was daytime.
Oh man,
this was daytime.
This is what that was what me and Evan used to do when we were kids. Like, I would go over his house and I would make him play Outbreak so I could watch him, because I couldn't play it myself unless someone else was there. But I liked watching other people do it because I knew I was too big of a chicken at the moment to be able to take on the consequences of being scared, of like wetting my pants and pooping my pants. But no, I'd make him play Outbreak, and it was so scary because he'd walk upstairs and zombies would just break your glass and try to reach for you, and it was just so sudden.
It was like the one I played, it was always dark. Like, you were in this like mansion like place, and it was all.
That might have been the first one, though.
Yeah, it was just dark. There was no lighting whatsoever.
That was probably the first one. The first one was based off of a mansion. Outbreak was based off of in Raccoon City.
Mm hmm.
But, like, in the beginning, you start off in a bar, like, nothing's wrong. And then, actually, oh,
yeah, I don't remember how it started. I think you just started off in a mansion.
That was probably one. Maybe it might have been two, but I don't know. Like, most after one were based off of Raccoon City, not the mansion anymore. But
it was creepy.
Nope.
I'm done.
That's how Slender. Difficulties.
Yeah, batteries died.
Batteries were too low. We've been talking for
quite a while.
Yeah, it had been an hour. Because my camera has like an hour and 50 minute record time.
So we've been talking for quite a while. But anyways, that's about the podcast. They're supposed to be long.
Yeah. But our last thing that we're going to get into, since we did finish the demo disc, basically the only thing we're really getting onto were horror games. We're going to quit that, but
we don't need this anymore, really.
Yeah. We want to get on to the social topic of do games make you a murderer, or are they an obsession or an addiction, basically? He can take it away.
Well,
his idea.
My idea. Like, for people say that games make you aggressive. No. I play Mortal Kombat, and they're killing a lot of people.
He doesn't hurt anyone, to be honest. I've never seen him.
I don't have an urge to go, hey, I'm going to rip your throat out. Because it's fun. I did it in Mortal Kombat.
I'm
going
to shove your head into your chest.
And rip your arms off.
Yeah, beat you with them.
But just because I play Surgeon Simulator don't make me a surgeon.
Exactly.
I don't think you want me operating on you. Unless you want me to operate on how I do in a certain simulator. Nope, don't need that. Don't need that.
Yeah, just throw the new thing in there. We're done.
Yep. Don't worry about putting the lungs back in. This is a heart transplant. But there's many people that say, hey, Call of Duty is making everyone kill each other. If you're killing someone, there's something wrong with you in the first place.
Or people sit there and they think that kids are getting more aggressive with insults and such because of Call of Duty. No. That's because, I hate to say it, but the adult doesn't restrict their insult meter. Or maybe they're just an anger person like me. I insult a lot of people.
And it's just being competitive. There's people in sports that get
exactly
mad, that get mad and that get competitive. I'm in sports. I used to wrestle. I'm a senior now, so it's over. But I played football. I've seen many people get mad over just being competitive. And playing games is just like a sport that you don't
people
move.
Do it as a sport. They have competitions. Dusty, he's been to a Super Smash competition because people can hit buttons like 60 buttons per millisecond.
they go fast. They go hard, and they go to win. You get big cash money out of this. They go there to be in a competition. Gaming is a competition. People cannot sit there and say that it's not.
And also saying that you have no life if you play video games. That is your life.
It's a hobby.
It's a hobby, and I grew up with video games. And it makes you feel good. It's like, if you like racing and you go to races all the time, don't... It's the same concept.
As of me saying that drinking water is an addiction. Why are you drinking water? You can drown in it.
It's your choice if you're going to be lazy or not. I guess I shouldn't.
I shouldn't compare it to water because you kind of need liquids.
You need liquids.
I would be more like saying you don't need your phone anymore. Electricity.
Yeah.
It's kind of like what we do. Anyway, it annoyed me because I remember one night, you don't need sports.
No.
You don't need it. But people that sit there in sports will say you don't need games. We get that. You don't need sports either. It's a hobby. We like to do it. It's something that makes you feel good. Sports. You do it because it makes you feel good. You like it. You play your sport with your friends and you have a fun time. You play your video games with your friends and you have a fun time. Why does it have to be such a different thing and people have to discriminate on the kids that play games a little harder than the others?
And then me and Stetson will talk in class about a game that's coming out or the story of a game.
And so we'll randomly just join in.
Yeah, they'll say that. Or you're stupid.
You guys are such nerdy or geeky. It's like we don't give a shit what you think. It's our thoughts. It's our choices in life. There's people that make more than you and your family by doing games.
Mm. And we just play games and we make people feel good.
And I did not mean to say that in such an insulting manner, but these people really annoy me. Because there's no reason for them to even be joining in the conversation or be a douche about it.
It's like, say, hey... Actually, they don't even need to say anything, really. It's like, it was our conversation, exactly. And they just jumped in and just...
And decided to insult us about our conversation.
It's like... And then you get those people that are like, quit playing video games, why don't you read a book?
Do I see you reading a book?
Yeah. And video games are books. Technically. It's a book that
you can interact. It's a visual novel.
It's a visual novel of a book that you can interact with. It's a movie in a book.
It's a big book.
It's a big book. It's a movie, a book, and a game all in one, pretty much. That's what a game is.
Here's my way of explaining it. If any of you have ever watched my Amnesia Let's Play, because even though it's an old game, I wanted to do a Let's Play on it for a long time because I wanted to get started with that because it's a fun game. It's an amazing story. There's no reason to play that game. There's no multiplayer, there's no online, there's no community other than mods, which will give you more stories. The game, there's no killing in it. There's death,
but you don't really see it.
There's story and just a hiding system from a monster. That's literally probably the only part of the game that's actually game considered, is hiding from a monster. Everything else is reading the notes and watching it and paying attention to the story. So all Amnesia basically is, and it gives you a fear factor from the hiding system. That's literally all. And the story.
And for those people that still think it's not like books, I'm not saying all games are like this, but they all have a story. They have a plot. They have characters. They have ideas, and then they have conflicts.
The only part about it is that you get to control
what
one of the characters inside the conflict. And not you don't even get to control what happens in some of them.
You get control of
how it goes about. The little middle parts.
And kind of like, instead of like, with reading a book, you're reading the word and you're kind of piecing it together in your own mind. With a video game, you're actually seeing it.
And you still get to piece it together in your mind because you do what you want. Like Arma. Actually, Arma 3's story is so interactive, and I love it, because you in the story get to pick your loadout of what your character is having, how you're going to go about the mission, and later on, you actually do, a little spoiler, you get to do a convoy assault, ambush, rebels. That's what they are, they're rebels for the country. It's a civil war going on, and you join the, basically like, how we joined Vietnam on the good side. in our minds, it was good side. I don't know who was good or bad, and I'm not going to say who was good or bad in case our viewers wanted Viet Cong to win, even though they technically did. And there's people that have conflicts over that, and I'm not going to get into that.
Yeah, we lost Vietnam, by the way. There's no doubt about that.
There's people that sit there and say, it was a tie.
No, we lost. We left.
We lost. We left. We forfeited.
That was a horrible, horrible war anyways.
Anyway, for what I was going on with, it lets you go about it how you want to go about it. And I was mainly getting onto this topic because people will be like, you don't have creativity if you have to play video games. It takes away your creativity. Sorry, it's actually adding a lot more creativity to it.
And they're like saying you're not learning anything from it. Like, there's like those strategy games that are like puzzles. You have to figure it out yourself. That brings up your puzzle challenging skills and your like strategies.
Exactly.
Some of them even have math in them. And like most of the war games are about history. I mean, they're not exactly, but it gives you a feeling of what it really was like. Like all the old Call of Duties.
Adds each little core spot that you can do in school. But Amnesia, there's a one level part, a little lever part where it had like the numerals rolls or whatever.
I forget Roman numerals.
Roman numerals. I don't know why. I remember that.
Got numerals part.
Yeah, I got numerals, but and you had to do 8-8, equal it up on top. So you had to sit there and puzzle it out and actually do the math of how it would equal up to make sure that both sides levers were making it equal 8. So people can't sit there and say it's not learnful for every game like Call of Duty, honestly. I can't agree with it because Call of Duty still is a game. And it still has a story, even if the stories are all sucky and the same. That's why we don't play Call of Duty. We played Advanced Warfare.
Just to see if what was changed, really.
And it technically did. I liked the story.
I liked the story in Advanced Warfare.
It was unique, and I liked the game style because it was the first one that added the exosuit, technically. Titanfall kind of had it, but not really. Mm-hmm. Wasn't really an exosuit, but for Call of Duty, it was a different gameplay style. There's able to jump and parkour and all that other stuff and get to a newer advantage.
It's like a faster pace for it.
Yeah, and there's a lot more strategies that you can go about to conquer your enemy. And the story was just really nice because, I mean, to shorten the story, and this is a big spoiler, so mute us or whatever right now if you don't want to listen. Alright, and the story was basically, you're a guy, friend gets killed, go to friend's dad's company, bad dad's company's corrupt, figure that out, join the real Marines again, take down the company. Mm-hmm. Which I don't know if you really fully take down the company or not. I think you do.
You kill the main person that made the company.
Yeah.
So
he was probably a little...
He didn't have a... It was his son that died.
And him later on.
Yeah, later him.
But yeah. I'm doing that sign so they can unmute us.
Okay.
We're done. You could unmute the spoiler part. But it was just... And it sounds really crappy when you shorten it up like that, kind of. But to play through it and feel the emotions of each character. Because voice acting takes a lot of skill. And to do that, it's like a movie. There's acting involved. There's actually usually nowadays... Arma, I know they actually did this for the characters in there, how they move. They had someone else in real life wear the suit with those little electromagnet balls or whatever to piece into animation.
Mocap suits?
Yeah. That's how they did all of it. So, you can't say there's no emotion put into it because it's their body motion. It's as if they're an actor in the game.
Mm-hmm.
So, and...
It comes in different art styles, too.
Exactly. Like, Walking Dead, they could have easily had something better graphic than that, mm-hmm. but they decided to go with a comic style thing because The Walking Dead was originally a comic. It wasn't a book. It was a comic.
And it wasn't a movie. And for those people that don't read. Exactly. I don't read either. I play video games. If they made a book, if they made a video game about every single book, I would be playing these video games.
We'd be
really well littered. I don't even... If they made these video games, books...
I leave you. Don't jump if you guys are doing this. Just do it.
You know, make
the... John, you put my stuffing in wrong. Will you take care of me forever?
References.
But yeah. No, and with the whole violence thing, that's not the game that brings it out in them. It's them that brings it out in themselves. Because like that's
how we went from.
Well, because we didn't really touch into the whole.
I know, we got
really deep into the whole book situation, yeah, but not the violent. Because there is a lot of people that would be like, oh, well, it triggers certain brainwaves to make you angry. If that's the case, I'm sorry, then why isn't half the population already attacking and killing each other?
Yeah, because the world was much more peaceful before we had video games. World War One, World War Two.
And if you
Vietnam.
And if you think about it, games bring people together. Because there's so many countries. Like, I know a YouTuber on there. His name's Samer M. And he's really cool. And he's from Austria. I do believe. No, he's not. That's another friend I mispronounced today. He's from Australia. I have another friend that's from Austria. And I have another friend from Denmark. I'm making friends from across the world. Sure, I don't get to see them, but I don't care. I get to play with these people. I get to be friends with them. And back then, you got made fun of or insulted for being black. That's really nice. When there's gamers nowadays making friends with black people, white people, Chinese people, they're being friends with everyone. And it's a nice cultural, we can get along with this. The only time we don't is if we're in a competition state. But okay, it's competition. In football games, are the people going to be sitting there yelling at each other when they're on the line? Yeah, they're going to be talking crap.
It's competitive. It's what brings the best in us. That's how the world was made, pretty much.
Exactly.
If we didn't have any competitive, we'd have all dandelions everywhere.
What did we leave off?
Violence.
It said something about dandelions.
Yeah. All right, we're back. Another technical difficulty.
We had an
interruption.
Yeah.
But the world is obviously made up of competitions, and it's going to happen. Who cares if people are yelling at each other? It's going to happen. And for the kids that go out and kill each other, or not kill each other, like the shootings,
it's not because of video games.
It's not because they're being influenced by a game. I'm sorry, they played games and they're already crazy. If they went out and killed someone else.
How many video game murderers do you see?
How many games,
serial killers do you see that play video games?
How many games do you actually see actually doing the stuff that they do?
You know.
Like, I mean, and it doesn't even get as detailed as that does. Grand Theft Auto, entitled, yes. It does do some of the stuff that they do, but not fully. Like, half of the stuff in there is kidnapping, and then you torture them till they're dead. The school shootings, I don't think there's any game you can play where you can actually kill a child.
Mm-mm. There's no game that has, like, Grand Theft Auto, you don't see one child. Nope. If they are, they're 18.
Yeah, they're overage, so they're technically an adult. So there's no game that allows you to kill children. Unless you mod it. Skyrim allows you to mod it to kill the kids. I thought about it because some of them are really annoying. But
I didn't even see any kids in Skyrim.
Yeah, there's a lot. Well, there's not a lot of kids in Skyrim. But there's kids in Skyrim.
I never saw them.
They're all in the cities. There's none walking around. Unless they're at a farm.
Yeah. I've never seen any of them. I probably have to go look and murder them. Might as well do it in real life, too, because while I'm at it. But yeah, it's a dumb thought. It's like, there are actually people trying to research this. How do you research this?
It's a game. People play games. And if anything, games are going to make people stop killing each other because they're going to be too busy sitting on their ass playing the game.
Yeah.
They don't want to get off. They're in the middle of a match.
Why do it in real life when you just do it on the game?
Exactly.
Because you get in trouble on it in real life and then you can't play games in prison.
Exactly. Why would you want to get in trouble in real life and then sit there and not be able to do the games again? Why not just do it on the game? You don't need the real life thrill.
Yeah. You get enough thrill from that.
Exactly.
And those people that do, they have something mentally wrong.
There's always something mentally wrong with them. Like, I know I forget where it was, but the shooting that was really big with the school shooting.
I don't know.
Some kindergarten teacher or whatever got shot up with some kids. The guy already had mommy issues. And the mom didn't treat him like a son. So, obviously, he's a little effed up in the brain. He's gonna go and do something absurd, and people tried blaming video games on this. Mm-hmm. It doesn't work that way. I don't understand how video games can be a cause of anything bad.
There has to, in order for you to get to the point of killing someone, you're either crazy or something has really impacted you. Like, really bad something.
They had to do something extreme.
Video games are fun and joyful. They ain't gonna, it's not gonna, hey.
Talk about my mom again on Xbox Live, man. I heard it. They don't do that. It's not something they do. If anything, they're gonna be like, your mama fat. Well, your mom's stupid. they say stuff like that. They insult each other, one and back and forth. And after that, they're done. They'll go tell their friends about how big of a douchebag they met, and the other one will do the same thing, and he'll move on with life. It's not going to be like, oh, I'm going to find him. He lives in Nebraska. I'm going to go there to his house and shoot him with a shotgun. It doesn't do that. And if anyone ever really honestly thinks that, it causes some sort of neuro, like, brain wave neuro. Crap. I don't know. I know it's, like,
neuro?
Neuro, whatever. I can't talk.
None of us can talk. We're from Indiana.
Oh, yeah. We're the homophobic state.
We are.
It sucks. Everyone's such close-minded.
I don't care. They do what they want.
It's not none of our business.
I'm not racist either. I just say nigger a lot.
That's a cultural bind. We can make friends with black people and then call them that instead of each other. They might hurt us, but
they're gonna hurt us.
They'll get used to
but it. But we're not racist. My grandpa's racist. That's what I grew up around. So I hear that word a lot, and it just
comes out. It really does. Same with curse words. I don't think curse words are bad. That's getting off the topic of games. Games are not bad. Games are good. Play games. Drink milk while playing games. Get your bones up so you can hit that D-pad more.
Yeah. And yeah, we're running out of time, so we gotta talk really fast. Not really. We can talk normal. But how are we gonna?
Sponsored by Toshiba.
Yeah.
You didn't even do that.
Yeah. And a word from our sponsors.
Milk. Just gonna put Photoshop milk in our hands. We're really holding milk right now.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
It fell through the floor.
Yeah, we're not sponsored yet. We better have friends.
But thank you guys for anyone that did pay attention and actually watch the whole thing, because we did kind of blabber on for a long time. We will see you in the next vlog, which will be hopefully every Tuesday. Hopefully. And if it's not, we'll put up a video on why. Why not?
Or Wednesday,
we'll just do Wednesday. Whatever.
But it's going to be on both of our channels.
Both of them.
And they may be, guys, yeah, they may be edited a little different, so.
But.
Vice versa.
And I had actually a proposition. I never told you because I figured this would be actually a really good thing. If the podcast gets 50 likes or favorites on either one channel, doesn't matter whose, as long as it gets to 50, either combined or separate, we should make our own channel for it. Because, I mean, it's not separate the channel, it's just because some people are going to want just that. They don't care. The other things are there. And people, hate to say it, people are going to complain. So, if you guys would like that, like this video. Get 50 likes, we'll make a separate channel for it. You subscribe to it, you'll have just our podcast, and you'll have a daily, or not daily, but Tuesdaily.
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 Once a week.
Yeah, once a week of us just blabbering on about games and things you may be interested in. And we didn't have an activity for this one because it was kind of really short-paced, or, you know, it wasn't planned out as well as our next ones would be. We just kind of wung it, or winged it, however you like to say it. I was trying to use past tense and it didn't work that well.
Wung it.
We wung it. Wong chong chong. But, and we'll do, like, activities like games or
Cards Against Humanity.
Anything you guys could even suggest in the comments below, and give us some suggestions on what we could talk about or anything else. Other than that, we're just gonna talk on our own,
or even like have like an advice session or
just
Q&A. Have like question answers, Q&A,
anything.
Strange wiki, and look up random strange things on wiki.
We could do the it's a game where you start on a random. That's been a little. Random wiki.
Oh, I played it, yeah.
And then you have to find something else. by clicking the blue links through the whole thing and see who would get there first.
Do like strange websites or something. Just some activity that we can do. You can put it in, like, actually I have another one for the next time we do this where you guys don't get to know it. But anyways, that's how
cute.
That's about all the time we have, really.
So
we're gonna keep blabbering on.
Thank you for tuning in to this weekly podcast.
We don't have a name yet.
Nope. Nothing.
We'll just call it
Cha Cha Cha.
We'll just call it the
Cha Cha Cha.
Cha Cha Cha.
Cha Cha Cha. I don't know.
No.
Pipsy.
Well, this is Bruce from Bruce Games and
Lord Stencil.
Logging off. I was waiting for you to
do your outro.
That's my outro.
I didn't know this was supposed to be horror, seeing those lasers.
Ow!
Quit shooting me!
I can't.